happened right here in our community. 10TV's Laura Borchers shares the senior citizen's story of torture and rape and uncovers the details of the man accused.
He beat me up and stomped on me, sat on me, kicked me.
This brave 81-year-old woman describes the night she says a man hid in her basement, then attacked her. For her safety, the victim and police asked us to conceal her identity.
And then he picked me up by my heels and was beating me on the floor to wake me up again, because I was unconscious at least two times that I know. The knife was right here.
For several hours, the elderly woman says it was in this room where she was cut, her ribs and back broken, and she was raped.
He beat me up by shoving his fist down my throat and had that knife at my throat. He cut my nose. He cut, stabbed me here, stabbed me here, stabbed me here, and cut my chin. And down at my privates, yes, he stabbed me down there.
Before being attacked inside her apartment, she tells us someone removed these plastic covers just below. There's a window that leads into the basement, and that's how she believes the suspect gained entry. Since then, she's replaced and locked those windows. Now, she's finding a sense of relief. Columbus police were relentless following the 2014 attack, and tonight, Sean Malone Jr. is charged with rape and kidnapping. Detectives say Malone is being investigated for a string of burglaries as well. He was in jail on one of those cases when police matched his DNA. This afternoon, they asked this 81-year-old victim to pick him out of a photo lineup.
I was to identify the pictures.
It brought back painful memories.
An HIV-positive man accused of sexually assaulting young girls, impregnating one of them, appeared in court this afternoon. 10TV News reporter Glenn McIntyre live at the Franklin County jail with details on this disturbing case.
Jerry, Keith Anthony Allen remains here on $1 million bond tonight. Today, while appearing in court, Allen said nothing. A public defender entered a not guilty plea on his behalf. Prosecutors say Allen has been HIV positive for 2 years. Starting last September through last month, they say he raped two 12-year-old girls, impregnating one of them, sexually assaulted a 14-year-old, and the 12-year-old victims is a relative of that girlfriend. His former girlfriend spoke with 10TV about how Allen's alleged crimes are impacting her family.
It makes me sick to even just sit here and think about how bad he's affected not just me, but having access to my family and doing what he did with them. It's just should never have happened.
Tells 10TV all four of the victims have been tested for HIV. She says at this point, all of their tests have come back negative. Allen's family was in court today for his first court appearance. They declined to say anything on his behalf. You'll find all of our coverage on this story on 10TV.com. Reporting live at the Franklin County Jail, Glenn McIntyre.